Hello, and welcome back to part two of our mostly blind let's play into Legend in the Sky. For future reference, for those of you who might want to play along with me on the computer, Z and X on the keyboard rotate the camera, which will come in useful for later, so. Yeah, I do actually like the music in this game, from what I've played so far. It's actually really rather nice. So, I suppose that's a compliment for the game. Now, in this City of Relent, for those of you who didn't see it, because it flashes by really quickly. Not too early, not too late. A wizard arrives precisely when he means to. Shut it, Gandalf. No offense to anyone religious. Really none. But I don't understand Sunday school. I get that it's supposed to teach you the Bible and whatnot. And no, they don't mean it in that way in this thing. It means legitimately school that just happens to be on the Sunday, so thusly Sunday school. Either that or it might be their equivalent to summer school. But then the kids they meet later on, after the training, it's very weird. But I assume it's just school that happens to be carried out on Sunday instead of throughout the week, like most schools. And, yeah, seriously, she, like, is conflicting herself. Because at the beginning, she's all excited to become a Bracer and so determined. Now she's, yeah, like this. Hopefully you don't have to run around clicking like a chicken naked or something. Did not intend for that to come out like it did, but it happened. Yep, thanks to last episode, my mind is still in the gutter. Huzzah! We get to move again. And for those of you who want to know the... Woo, that's awesome! the general goods store is where you want to find the paper. And I assume his name is Renan. Renan. He's an Anon! Watch out! He has the magics. Yes, I do spend time on Tumblr. But I'll be also fair. I hate Facebook. And I'm not the biggest fan of Twitter. So, out of all of those public domain media things, I tend to prefer Tumblr out of anything else. Heh, she's after shoes. Of course. I still don't know how to pronounce that school? What's a school? Well, I suppose it's a street way to say shoe. School, you dummy. For future reference, yes, I do stumble over my words a lot. And I tend to make fun of myself for it. But, so it shouldn't be that bad. I'll try my best not to make too many mistakes, so I don't get laughed at. Oh wait, that's the entire point. Oh, there's that glittery sound effect again. Bla bla bla. I apologize. I yawned again. So unprofessional. Well, at least we'll know that to come here after training. Quick tour. General goods. Armory. Guild. Magic store. And not quite magic, but they'll explain it shortly, for those of you who haven't seen the series before. And this is yet another character. Aina, I assume? Aina? I got nothing. I'm sure someone will tell me how to pronounce it. Oh, we're about to meet Charizard in person. Get your Pokeballs ready, people. Yes, good luck fighting a fully leveled Charizard for our first-time trainers. Gasp! How tough it'll be! Yes, I will be making Pokemon jokes every time the Miss Charizard is around. Mostly because, I mean, seriously, look at her name. And that would be Charizard! Yep. Wow, Charizard has appeared. It appears to be reading. Sorry. Wheel of Fortune! Oh wait, she said the inversion. Gazel! This! Wheel! I got nothing. That's the best I can do for trying to say Wheel of Fortune backwards. But then again, I was just saying gibberish. Oh, and like last time, I will try and get through this as quickly as possible. So, and apparently these two are notorious for being late. Not gonna blame Joshua, I'm gonna blame her. All her fault. She broke the plate. Tried to stop her, but she had to demonstrate her apple chopper. For those of you who actually know that, bravo for sitting through VeggieTales. And yes, even though I myself am not Christian, I did grow up watching VeggieTales, and even though I'm still not Christian, I still don't mind watching VeggieTales. It's still actually kind of fun. And funny, usually. Ready! Quiet, you. Enthusiasm dropping! It's under 9,000! Yes, all forms of referential jokes. Mean, but you will find out this is so true, that instead of letting it dribble out of your ears, while it's not exactly a vote of confidence, it's true. Watch. Also, stop being a brat. Seriously. Also, I like him. While Estelle may hate studying, rarely ever does her homework, acts rashly, is overly naive, has a tendency to stick her nose into everything, her instincts are sharp. Awesome. Insult her and compliment her at the same time. Bravo! Bravo! Takes an expert. Eventually, probably. Great vote of confidence there. Not even the other characters like her. And here's yet another example of how observant she is. Ready? Ta-da! give a gold star to the observational one. Yes, a singing Lion King, cause I can. Yeah, he probably did. Whatever. Now, I'll be fair. I live with two redheads. They tend to retaliate tenfold. An insult will likely get you punched. So I'm surprised she's not trying to Goomba stomp him again. And while personally I have no experience with tarot cards, I know they can, a lot of people do go to them for some form of future reading. And to be fair, if I had to choose between how I wanted my future read between crystal ball and tarot cards, I go with tarot cards. Only reason is because if it's a legitimate tarot, a tarot card dealer that trusts the cards, she'll let you shuffle the deck. If it's not one, they'll shuffle the deck and they'll manage to stack the deck somehow. Side tangent aside, that's certainly a way. Well, she can read the cards. They clearly have what they're called, and she said what they're called, so clearly she can read them, but she can't read them. Read? Now, as I said before, I will be skimming through this all, through all of this as quickly as I can. As quick as I can, because trust me, I'll be a little bit mean. Fair warning, we're about to be skipping a few lines of important dialogue. Not really. Ah, I failed miserably. I thought there would be more dialogue. Dumbass. Not any of you, me, obviously. Okay, so since we can't, we'll go through this. This is the kingdom we reside in, and blah 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 tradition, blah 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 things, and so on. Oh, the little tiny crystals are the septum she's talking about. Fair warning. Although, I kind of wish that it was the currency, because, to be fair, in most RPGs, you see gold, silver, copper as the main form of currency, but really, not very many other forms of currency. I'd actually like to see gems be a currency. And to be fair, I've even toyed with the idea. No, while I'm not a game maker exactly, I do fiddle around with game ideas and things like that. I can at least make the words appear faster so that we can get through this quicker and not get into the actual game. So that way, we're not sit here I could be clicking it along like that. By the way, seriously, these things look like those little pocket watches. They do! And to be fair, I've never seen a real-life pocket watch. And I kind of want one because they look cool. I mean, they do. Even though they're old-timey, they still look cool. At least, personally. But then again, I'm more of a fan of older things than modern-day stuff. I like older music, like Elvis and Beatles and things like that. I like some older video games, but not many. Oh, and for those of you wondering, even though I've been mentioning Mario, I actually do not like Mario whatsoever. I actually prefer Sonic over the two. Yes. Yes, fanboys! Hate me! Hate me! I feel better. Although, I'm pretty sure... Oh, wait, no, wait. I'm 100% sure I'm having all the Mario fanboys hate me in the comment section below. That'll be fun! Yeah, apparently she doesn't like sitting at a desk. And seriously, she just explained it and had to re-explain it to this rather dense girl. Ugh. Yeah, she... Like she said earlier, if it doesn't involve my whole body, I get sleepy. Yeah. That's not... Oh, whoops. Sorry, folks. You're gonna have to pause the video. I didn't mean to triple click. I meant to double click, and I did it again. I'm used to the dialogue going a little bit slower. Ow. Sorry, I've got a cut in my forehead, and it's bugging me. So, yep. Prime example of me stumbling over my words. Anyways, so we'll be doing a tutorial quest. Yeah. Boop-a-doo. There we go. By the way, I love the response they give, or rather, don't give, in Estelle's case. Basically, these are the in-game Pokédex. Yes, as long as Charizard's around, I will be making Pokémon references, just because I can. Basically, it'll automatically record knowledge. It's the in-game storybook, basically. The color of the sky today is blue. Okay. Tomorrow. Yep. Color of the sky. Still blue. Not a clue. Maybe should stop writing. Seriously, no matter how insignificant they may seem, you should write it down. So I should write down every detail that I notice. Even I would think... I think I would ask for a clarification, more or less. Even though that would make me sound dumb, I don't care! I would literally say, so, should I be writing down what the color of the sky is? And things like that? At least she tries to back out, to try and... cover her tracks. That's the word I was looking for. I should be better at this whole speaking thing. But I'm not. But that's half the fun. Okay, let's test her observation skills one more time, guys. Yep, they noticed it. By the way, I like the little noise they make. Is this annoying? I don't know. Probably. Sorry. I'm a goofball, and that's okay. Let you folks read the out-of-character stuff. Because it's more or less a... all one big tutorial. And yes, this is definitely a JRPG. Although currently, our opponent seems to be the greatest opponent of all. Reading. Gosh darn it, I'm committing the worst cinema sin. Reading. I'm forcing you all to read, oh no. Your days will be ruined. You have to sit here and read. But of course, if you don't care, you'll just listen to my voice. Except for the awkward pauses when I'm just letting you all read. Oh, so, good to know. Try and keep talking. Well, of course she's had a change of heart. She wants to be the very best like no one ever was. Catch the Charizard! Is the real thing. I got nothing. Who doesn't play Pokemon, by the way? I think everyone ever has played Pokemon at least once in their life. Oh great, we'll be explaining the magic of this reality. Okay. More tutorials, folks, so once more, much like this, I will try my best to get you through it quickly so we can get into the actual action. Although, we'll be cutting the video one more time before any actual action happens, because the last time I did this, recorded this, it took a full hour to record everything, including all the combat. So, for those folks who have stuck with me so far, bravo, but just a warning, the actual fun will be beginning next video. And I'll probably do at least one combat to at least whet everyone's appetites, at the very least, so I'm not mean. So these are the crystals that you saw in the little picture. So, apparently they're dropped by monsters and whatnot. Okay, so, I personally think time should be gold for sand, space should be black. Seriously, they should flip these two colors. Only complaint. Why am I pointing at the screen when you totally can't see me? Well, whatever. Imagine you can see me. Let's go with the ornaments that they were talking about earlier. These are the pocket watches. Every character, every character I've come across, translation only these two, has one, so. Blah 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 blah. Sorry. I've got ADHD. I do not like sitting through long-winded tutorials like anybody else. I prefer more Western RPGs like Fallout, the New Wastelands, the Old Wasteland even, or Underrail, which I will also be playing on this channel, and soon, so look forward to that. I haven't seen many people do intros of that, but then again, it's still in early access, since it's being worked on by a small team. But we'll certainly get as far as we can into the game. For sure. I should totally have turned off the notifications. Oh well. It's no big deal. I don't generally get a lot of those yet. And I agree, they probably should have been called arts in the first place. But yeah, mostly currently, to me, this is blah, 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 because I have legitimately read this at least once, while I know you guys haven't. So, for the first video, that cutscene, that they showed with all the characters, that was too loud and had trouble with. And to be fair, I'd probably have the same issue this time. You might have heard me now and again when I brought the microphone extra close. But since I'm using a headset microphone instead of a table stand one. And lastly, quartz. Oh! Don't you hate that when you yourself are playing a game and accidentally re-click something even though you meant to go click somewhere else? Sorry. I don't care anymore! I want to get into the game! Okay. I promise that'll be the last time I do that. Unless, of course, you folks like that. But it's just a tutorial currently. I swear, when it gets into the actual game, I won't do that. But still, come on. Anyways, we should buy one of each. One of these things doesn't belong here. Yes, it just popped in my head. Yes, me. I don't belong here. I belong in an insane asylum. So, Joshua, clearly, and these are the ornaments, is only allowed to use time quartz currently. And Estelle, stop doing that, is allowed all the quartz. And for future reference, if you want to make the tutorial go quicker and you're playing this yourself, install a... How does she have less health already? How did she start off with less health? She must have gotten slapped. Start with the HP quartz. So that when you talk to Charizard again. Oh. For those of you who are interested, right-click to talk to people. More blah blah blah. And also, for fair warning, definitely open Joshua's first, his little crystal thing, because you only get enough to open one of them. Open Joshua's first, because he's restricted to the time crystal, and you will get and even the game will compliment you. So, here, look. See? Good work opening up a slot. Since your essential slot is limited to a certain element, it would be best to increase your orbman's number of slots early on. See? For those of you who have been reading, she was told about a test earlier. And she's already forgotten. Again. I want to strangle you. At the very least, I'll punch your little character. See? Ugh. She has worse short-term memory than me. And to be fair, I don't have that bad of a short-term memory. I'm just joking. If it weren't for the fact that I watched Mythbusters, I would say she has the memory of a goldfish. But since that particular statement is not true, I can't exactly say it. adult. See? Sometimes I fear for the future of the Bracer Guild. And humanity. Kill her off! It'll save humanity! Kill the cheerleader! Save the world! I've only watched the first season of Heroes. And barely. Less yapping, more walking. More kidnapping. Help me! And yes, this is how I would respond. I would ignore the ever-living daylights out of her. I will try and keep this mostly PG slash PG-13-ish. Although, to be fair, when I play M-rated games, I suppose that's no real use. So, I would ignore the fuck out of her. I'll remember this! One day I'll get my revenge like any other evil villain! Yes, I totally treat her like an evil villain. Because she tests my patience. She really does. Yet another example of her ineptitude. And we're watching. And we're watching. Yep. She forgot already. And see! Okay, I agree with Charizard here. You just read what it said on the bulletin board. And she's still dumb. And she made her jot down everything in the notebook. She's the dumbest person on the face of this planet. Why must you be the main character? Please die. I don't want you to be the main character. You're so stupid. See, that's the sound effect I was talking about in the first video. Yeah. I'm with him. No, you're trying to be stupid. I apologize. I'll explain it when we get in. Like I said, I've been through this before, and I kind of want to at least show you guys something. For pity's sake. Healing and a monster guide. Record information on monsters and whatnot. Basically, the Pokédex. Yes, I'll keep making Pokémon references since Charizard's still here. At least we have Joshua as our as one of the main characters. So at least we know we have one smart person and one really, really dumb one. Well, I suppose this is an Abbott and Costello routine. He's the straight man, she's the comedy relief. Who's on first? What's on second? I don't know who's on third. Okay, we're in the game. I'll be saving here. Let's see. I ended the first video around the 47-minute mark-ish. And this one's only been going on for, I don't know, about 20 minutes. And these are basically save points. Some sort of. They don't let you... you can save anywhere in the game, but these will restore your health. And since... for some reason... she starts off with less health, we'll be healing her right off the bat. There we go. Now, we're finally down into for real, actual gameplay. Let's celebrate with a tutorial battle! Yay! More tutorials. Boo. Well, at least it's something different in combat, so... basically, we're down here to retrieve an item. That's right, I promised I'd explain everything that I basically skipped over, because I just wanted to, I really wanted to actually show you people some combat instead of just boring talk. And trust me, I know it's boring. And let's... yes, yes, tutorial. Yes, tutorial. And let's send him after the other one. And these monsters won't... these first monsters won't attack you. Anyways, we're down here to retrieve some items from down below. And we're to bring them back. Still like the music. And we actually get to hear the characters' voices in battle. See? And these are the Sephrom that they were talking about that drop from monsters. You'll get them every time, and you'll also get items. Which you later find out sometimes are for cooking, sometimes are just for selling and whatnot. And here's a tutorial battle on how to use magic. Or rather, arts, as they call it. So like a group of flies, it's hard hit it at them all, which I have, like I said, I've played through this once before. I never did explain why the video of this one didn't make it. While sure, if I re-recorded the first one, this one should have made it out too. This particular one, first time recorded it, it was muted. Professionalism! And just make them each point a magic at the enemy and watch them die. By the way, I did not expect that to be her voice. She does, however, you know, thinking about it, does kind of fit her character. You know, the tomboyish. And it's a tomboyish type voice. Roger that! Yes. And this is all just tutorials and whatnot. And crafts are like art, but physical. So, for example, she's a support character. I'll encourage you with words! And he's the actual attack character. So, there's that. Ow. And this should kill it. Wow. I don't think I've ever missed in this combat. Well, at least she killed it. the one shot. Now, down here is a chest, and you folks might find this funny. So you open it the first time, you get the item. In this game, every single chest has a different one of these little things. So always check the chest twice, because they usually have a funny, funny saying. The chest is empty because of you. Nice work, hero. Nice work. Pat on the back. There. Nice work. Nothing down this way, so don't have to worry about coming down this way. Oh, surprise! Another creep thing. Is she seriously getting bored of combat? We're not! But then again, it's more tutorial combat stuff. So, yay! But at least it's combat, for pity's sakes, instead of... for... that bloody, stupid... tutorial... malarkey. And these are the S-crafts. Basically, these are the super moves. So, boop. And much like it'll explain here, you can ignore a battle order. And use your super move at any time. Kill you with stick poking! Ah! Sorry. Oh, eeny, meeny, miny, that one. At least his kind of looks cool. And makes sense for... ow. Oh, you know what? I totally forgot to slot another one of those gems into his orbit. Oh well, it's not the worst. Besides, it's really easy. Just do that. Yes. And I generally give him evade since he seems to be the roguish character. Or at least the few times I've played it so far. Yet another tutorial. But, like it explains, there are turn bonuses and things like that. Both you and the opponent get them. See? So, this will heal you, this will... etc. So... if you want to cash in on these, you should attack the opponent. You get bonuses for it. I may have to use one of our items. And he won't move, the others will. Ooh, yeah, definitely going to have to use a healing. Oh, please, live! Okay. Anyways, I was forced to use an item. Oh well. As long as the characters don't die, right? And later on, I might... if the combat starts becoming boring, then I might... skip the combat too, but seriously, he was right in front of you. How did you miss? He was 2 feet in front of you. extra plus, though. Well, at least they missed. And they missed. Pew, pew, pew. And yes, you can hit these with melee attacks. It's just hard. You can do it, though. Let's see if I get lucky. Like that. Now, if you want to just win without getting close up, just do this. Just cast art and he won't do anything. He'll just sit there. Ta-da! And thanks to all the extras, we get a lot of Sethum. And that would be the tutorial quest all said and done. And of course, here's another example of Estelle being dumb. But then again, I suppose every cat is dumb. I don't know, she's just being curious, and curiosity killed the cat and so on. You're no fun at all! Yeah. Good old honest curiosity. Mm-hmm. We can get it away with a teensy weensy peek! Right? I punch her. Did you just say the F word? No, he said flunking. Pretty sure he didn't say fuck. So rude. Yes, but how would you know it's nothing illegal unless you opened it? But I just can't help myself. Now, you can't help yourself at all, can you? By looking inside this chest again, you flunk. Just kidding. Whee! Super fast! Super fast! Anyways, let's see how long the combat took. We'll finish up above ground by finishing off this little tutorial stuff and begin the actual game, more or less. And Joshua was thankfully right. I figured she would try and set us up like that, so. That's for me to know, and you to find out, after your training. Nah, sorry. Come on, Charizard, please! Give us the boxes! Are they Pokédexes? Or what was it Professor Oak had delivered to him? I think it was like an old Pokeball or something. Doop-a-doop-a-doo-doo-doop-a-doop. Sorry. I got, my mind just started wandering because I was like, words, too many words. I don't mind reading, but not in my games. I play my games for fun, and I am having fun. This is fun. talking to you folks and making a fool of myself for your general amusement. I find that fun. But sitting here having to read, it's so boring. But we'll be done quickly. And report. Yay. We now have 1,000 Mira. Or gold. I'll probably just keep calling it gold, because I don't know what the money actually looks like. Ow. Sorry, I popped my neck. BP. Well, at least it's not an oil company. And work hard. Yep. Stop calling us to earn oil company. I don't want to earn an oil company. Although that would make me really rich. Okay, we'll earn an oil company. To the bone. She seems easily intimidated. Bow chicka bow wow. To be fair, if there have been any sexual jokes in the past, I haven't noticed them. This one I did. Well, recently I meant. From real world experience. Okay, let's go push Estelle down the stairs. See what she learns from that. Let's hope she learns to stop being stupid. Sorry. She really, really rubs me the wrong way. Oh, Charizard gave us our Pokédexes. Well, in truth, it's actually these things. Any day now. Yeah, you get a little tiny badge. Ahem. Estelle Bright, Joshua Bright. Yep, definitely adopted him. Oh, they go by military time. Not surprising, since it seems to be a warrior's guild. Bloop! Like the noise it made. Yes! Not that long ago, I expected to be dead. Now, I'm a bracer. How amazing. He boggles my mind. Ow, ow, ow. Sorry. My headphones were attacking me. That's something you don't hear every day. Except for Markiplier. His most recent video where he's just dancing. His headphones slip off and attack him. And like Joshua said, well, he was having a good day. Till his eardrums bleed. Did she really have to shout that loudly? I mean, really? She has a lot to make up for. Yes, a lot of trouble. Especially for Estelle, who needs, like, mental tutoring. If it weren't mean, I'd call her some very, very crude words, but I at least have some tact and won't call her that. Because I know it will offend a lot of people if I call her certain things. So, not gonna. Because I know what lines not to cross. Well, generally. And Charizard's off. And once more, she's lost. Not surprising. She's always lost. This is Charizard! Oh, it's a silver Charizard. Oh, great, it's shiny! Definitely must catch it then. Why does she hold Dad in such high esteem? Seriously. He's probably the best bracer there is. Honestly speaking, it is a JRPG. It's more than likely the case where her father happens to be the very best. And of course, she'll manage to surpass him in a couple games when they come out. But still, I don't care. It's just one of those. It's no doubt that, for now, he's the best there is. A no good middle-aged man, huh? Yeah. And it definitely doesn't surprise me that that's how she sees her father. She's ungrateful! No, I'm not old. I just don't like her. To be fair, I'm not a fan of kids. They bother me intensely. And we're back. Oh, that would have been fun. Anyways, I'll be ending the video here. So next time will be the game's actually finally started. So for you folks that stuck around through this, bravo. If not, well, I'll be talking to some of you folks for the very first time in the next video. Hope you all enjoyed it. Hope that we'll all get along. And, I will see you all next time. Toodles!